I'm here with Domino from StamperDog.com, and let me tell you, we are going to play with some fun new stamps I just got yesterday. So let's get started.
Stamper, come.
Well, I hate to tell you, but the dog is a little tardy to the party. He has been getting trained today, and let me tell you, at some points I was very proud of him, and at other points I was just kind of, that's my dog. Yeah, right. I'm bringing in your comments right now because I can't wait to see you. Oh, Patty. Oh, hey, Patty, did you get my email? That was just for you, and I still love you no matter what your answer is. But I know what it should be. Oh, Deb's here. Kathy's here. Oh, and the dog is, well, he's somewhere. They did tell us not to chase him, and I don't. Yeah. So let's look at and see what we did with that card on that we did on Monday. Yeah, and if you're here on the replay, we've got some fun stuff here. We make a card together, and you get to decide some of the things. Now, I've got to tell you, if you look in today's post, this shimmer paper looks like it's blue, like a dark blue, but not a dark blue, but like a robin egg blue, right? But it's not. It's really white, and it kind of, like today, it kind of looks blue in my monitor, you know, in my, like, for real when I'm looking at it. And then when it's sometimes it looks a little green, who knows, but I like the way I ended up with it. Do we have a dog coming? Yeah, well, don't chase him. He'll come when he wants to. It's not like Stamper was. I just walk in here, the dog follows me, and he sits down. And, you know, I mean, I didn't train him to do that. He just did that, okay? And, yeah, I miss that dog. I miss that dog. But, you know, it's an adventure. It was really great. We were playing with him, and it's the first time we've had to go at 2 o'clock in the afternoon because, you know, I don't know about where you are. They give all these numbers and statistics and everything, and they say it's going down some places. Well, we had in our little community of like 60,000 people in two towns, right? And then we have two counties, right? 1,000 people got sick yesterday. Well, that was over the weekend. They count the weekend. Or no, yes, yesterday was Tuesday. So no, that was just for Monday. Yeah. But yeah, I'm glad you like the way this turned out. Yeah. So let me get out this new stamp set. Here it is. Garden Greenhouse. Did you check this out? I'm going to do it one way and you can imagine doing it another way. But I want to show you what I did. I used some of this new daffodil paper that you can get for free with a $50 order. I thought about putting this in the background, but boy, that would be, that'd be kind of big, right? And I thought about doing these, that would be great too. My husband, I think he was napping out in the kitchen when I said, hey, I'm going, I'm on. And he didn't say anything. This would have been nice in the background, yeah. Not going down where I live. Okay, so since I got you here, let's do one of these here real quick. I am so proud of myself. I am so proud of myself before I even get started on this. Or maybe as I do, you know, I was wondering if you noticed, I have not shown my fine tip glue. Right? I haven't shown my fine tip glue. And recently. Well, that's because I didn't know where it was. Well, Stampin' Up! Had sent me this nice little set, and one little holder holds my trimmers now. And I just noticed, wow, look at how this is the quality of workmanship thing. And this isn't Stampin' Up. This is just, look at, this one's even, well, kind of even. It's tied over here, right there. And then this this is close and this is kind of close, but this one, look at, they almost went off the edge of the box. I mean, but you know what? I didn't even notice that till just now. And you know, you wouldn't either, you know, but it was the perfect place for me to put that. Look, because I already have a holder for my Tombow glue that we have this, you know, and it's always upside down, always ready to go. And there's a holder. I think there's a link to the holder over at StamperDog.com/likes, right? But there's a link to these. And what's good about these is that you get 10 bottles. And like you use one or maybe two, and then if it gets clogged up, you go and just switch out the top and throw away the bottom of the next one. And so you don't waste any glue. Well, you know me, I put them in that special place and I don't know where my other 9 bottles are, right? Oh my goodness, everybody is chatty over on Facebook, and Patty's over there on YouTube, and boy, you know, you'd think she'd be by herself, you know, but she's not, because I'm with you, Patty. So anyway, so it did clog up, but I had a really long needle and I put it through there, and because I'm going to use it today. So here, let me go and do this while I think about it. Yeah, you guys are having a... Do I have the right glasses on? Yes. So how about this? The saga of the hairdresser, you know, I had the same hairdresser for 27 years, longer than I claimed to be alive, right? Like since I was 13. Anyway, come on. It doesn't, yeah, this is the hardest thing you'll do, especially when you can't see it. You know, the teacher was teaching us some of the ways to get your dog today, and you just have to trick them sometimes. You don't chase them, and I can hear him coming down the hall. Well, the referee is here. Hi. Hi, buddy. How you doing? Oh, he tugged on his. Oh, you burped. You burped. Are you okay? He's been having so many treats today. He's had duck treats. He's had pepperoni. Yes. Oh, and I'm glad that you're just in the good mood now. Because this morning he was in his nippy mood. But all he had to do was chase his little friend Mitzi around. Chase her around the dog class and for a little while. And what are you looking at over there? There's nothing over there for you. It's everything for you is right there. See, look at right there. Ooh, did you eat too many treats today? Oh, you poor thing. You poor thing. Yeah. Oh, yeah. We got to have that yawn. Are you going to yawn? Okay, Mr. Clemmer. Yeah. So, yes, He's very good. He doesn't nip me when we go to class. I think he's had too many treats. Has he been eating that food?
A little bit.
Yeah, we got him a new dog bowl. Yeah. Oh, such is the saga of having a new puppy. Yeah, right. So anyway, here we have all these little ones here. Hi, Tammy. Jekyll and... Yes, I talked... Do you know what? And it's not just that shirt. It's really any tighter shirt. Oh, ooh, that pinched me. Oh, ouch. It's really any snug fitting shirt. You're right. It's like night and day. And I talked to the trainer about it today, but she, you know, come on, she's a PetSmart trainer. She's very nice and she knows a lot of things, but she's not a dog behaviorist. Okay. But she can tell you a lot about him. I'm not discounting her knowledge at all. But she's not Kay, okay? And hold on, let me get the two that I used already. One, two. See, these come with it. That's what really made me think, oh, I like that, right? I like it a lot. if you're wondering where you get these magnets, and we have tested them out so that they hold. Gotta put it down the right way though. And I'll show you in just a second. Because look at, I pinched myself getting this one off. There. I just got to get these last couple in here. But I'm so happy we found these magnets. Yes. These magnetic sheets, that's where you get them, because we've tested them. Not all of them are as strong as these, and you can buy some and they'll fall right off. In fact, you know, those of you who have been around a bit, know I tell the story about, see, look, there, done. About the lady who had these beautiful, beautiful little cabinets and everything. And then she had inside the door, she had all these, you know, this great big sheet, magnet sheet, and she had her dies up there. And then when you could hear when she moved on, she shut the door and you could hear them go tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. Yeah, that's why it's great to have ones that have been tested. And yes, they work. So anyway, so here we go. I don't know what, look what I got to give away tomorrow night. Someone's gonna win this. And how about this? This is like the also ran prize. How you gotta love that. So, you know, here I went and I brought that out and I'm gonna show you what. I had these here. Oh, here. Here we go. I cut this out of the daffodil paper. And then I cut this out and I did not, and I'm going to tell you, I did not put the adhesive sheets on the back. Golly, I'm going to have to put some white behind there so you can see that. I didn't put any adhesive sheet on the back only because I was afraid that it would not cut all the way through. Well, actually, it wasn't so much that as I was afraid that once I laid it down, I would just not have that hang time like I have with. I like how Beverly thinks. like I would with glue. And so, you know, I just got this yesterday. I have not even used it, but this is, and when I laid it down, I've got to tell you, I took it like this, right? I took it like this, and I want you to be thinking about what background we should have on this card. And I held the die over it, and really right here at the end was really the best place to have it. So it would show the most amount. Now let's see, I've moved things, you know, but this little Teflon mat that we sell is great to have for times like this, because I'm going to be using this little puppy. Now, what background should we use? Should we use the bumblebee? Should we use, there is a little pink in here. I'm not using both. I'm telling you that now. I think I'm going with the bumblebee. Boy, I'm going to take my glasses off for this. Ah. Oh, golly. And Beverly, are you talking about you want that prize for the also ran prize? Yeah. Well, you know, and I have one from the last celebration. You know, I thought about leaving all these little dots in there so that it would. So it'd be easier. But this, you know, you could try it with the adhesive sheets. I think that would be a good idea. I know Kay would be able to just bang it out real quick, but it would be just my luck that it would go on there unevenly. And it, like, I didn't take all these dots out because guess what? I didn't want to, and I don't have to. Okay. There. So there. Where are my magnetic sheets from? Well, if you go to stamperdog.com/likes, there you go. And I can almost bet that they're not from the U.S., if that's what you're asking. In my world, I would have everything made in the U.S., but sometimes that's just not reasonable. And that's not my fault. Hold on. I was really glad to see something hit our newspaper. Your glue must be old. Well, yeah, this has been sitting here for a couple months, and I did have to go and bang start it. So, you know, like stab it. Hold on, my husband's going to bring me. Hold on, my hands are full. And this is how I would do this. If something... Oh, did I put it on the top? Yes, I did. I'm not sure. We'll find out in a second. But the good part about this is that the... even if I did get it on a part that I didn't want it on... It's not going to matter because it won't stick to this. Okay, I talked to some of you. This has to do with that supply chain thing. And I did talk to some of you about this, but I forget when, you know, come on. Or my brain's not indexed, okay? But I did want to show you this. This finally made it to our small town newspaper. That is, when I was talking about, you know, how sometimes things can go missing from Amazon to you and vice versa. And who knows, maybe even Stampin' Up, who knows? I don't know, that hasn't happened to me yet, knock on wood. But this is down in LA where people are breaking into the railroad cars. Yes. Isn't that horrible? And then they just toss off what they don't want. And the local news station had gone down there and they had found a couple packages that were being mailed back to Amazon. And they contacted the people and said, did you know that your stuff's just sitting here next to the railroad tracks? I mean, and so I hope that they do something about this. And this is, that's what thieves do. They go in. It's easy to break into the railroad cars. They just break in. They take what they want. Let's say there's somebody's test kit in there that they're sending back for results and it goes missing. Well, now you know where it is. It's somewhere down there in LA. So anyway, yeah, if it's in my local newspaper, it's got to be in the national news. But where I saw it was way ahead of this. This is from the Orange County Register and the Tribune News Service. So, yeah. Okay. I mean, our area is more concerned about this is the local two high schools playing and you see all the faces there that you shouldn't see. Yeah. And then we wonder why we have 1,000 people. Yeah. So anyway, that's okay. Yeah. See, that happens. Okay, Kay, you saw it yesterday, but I told you about it last week. You know, hey, girl's got to be up on her news, and I don't watch much news, but what I watch, I do, yeah. So what has anyone, okay, Pear Pizzazz, we got, Elaine wins, because she's the only one. Oh, wait, oh, and Kay said Bumblebee, so I'm going to bring them both out, and we're going to look and see what they're going to look like. Now, on the bumblebee, we could use, hold on, oh, wait, here's one. This isn't either one of those. Hey, look at, it didn't, there. There's that. And there's, hold on. I don't want, ooh. It's got to be light and bright. It can't be, dark, because if it's that's too dark already. Okay, so bumblebee and Pear Pizzazz. And this is why I like my stuff alphabetized, because I know where it is. Okay, so that's Pear Pizzazz. That's Pure Pizzazz. And here is Bumblebee. Now, the colors that they tell you are Basic Black, Crushed Curry, Daffodil Delight, Evening Evergreen, Flirty Flamingo, Mint Macaron, oh my goodness, Mossy Meadow, Pale Papaya, Pear Pizzazz, and Very Vanilla. So there's no Bumblebee in here. It's Daffodil Delight. How about that? Oh, see, now Elaine says it has shift to Bumblebee. Now, what kind of background should we do? I'm like, And should we go? I'm thinking. Sometimes I put it like this and I stare at it and then it just comes to me. It comes to me. It's like, see, Bumblebee's not even on there. That's interesting. So let's, Crushed Curry is not that different, but it is brighter. Oh, see, Tammy says Pear Pizzazz is her favorite. See, this Crushed Curry. Okay, well, we're going to try the Flamingo just to see. You know, I have to walk 6 steps to get over here. You know, it's just really tiring. But I'll do anything for you. I hope you take that in the manner in which it's given. Oh, look at that. There's Flamingo. Golly, there is no. But we have to look and see what. Yeah, I'm thinking this. I'm thinking, yeah, for our background. I'm still not deciding this because, you know, I'm if Barbara were here, she would say this, right? And you could have both of these here. There's nothing saying that it's not, it's an all sum game. See, and everybody's saying Pear Pizzazz, and I'm like going, well, I could. I'm just wondering if. Okay. How wide is this puppy? It is 3 inches wide. So we're going to cut this like 3.5. By 4.75. Okay, then I'm going to pick something different. Oh, okay. I came up with something while I'm off camera. You don't mind. Oh, it's going to have everything you want. I don't know about everything you need, but it's going to have everything you want. Okay, so that was 3.5 by, so this is going to, it's going to be a layer that is, I hope this turns out well. What's the worst that could happen to me? Oh. I cut this border layer 3/16 inch larger because I don't want it to be really way different. We'll see. Gonna definitely have to put a layer in this. I mean, you know, like a liner in it. Oh, I cut the wrong one. Isn't that great? That's okay. That's the worst thing that happens to me. Now, if you like any of these things that we've used today, let me go and cut this really quick, the right color. That's where you're going to find them. Is at shopwiththedog.com. And those are all the things that I give all of my online shoppers. Yes. Yeah. You know, I'm a bit of a color snob, just like I'm a bit of an adhesive snob. Oh, I am going to pear. I am going to pear pizzazz, Kay. So there. Okay. So look at, here's that crushed curry. We're going to put this on here. How do you like that? And it's just 3/16 larger, so it's not really going to really impact it a lot. And then we're going to take the mossy meadow. Okay, you scorers, you're going to have to blink right now because you know me. Okay, how do you like this? And then this. You like that? Or, I mean, I could reverse this stuff at any time. But then we'll put a greeting up there. We'll call it good. And I hope you like that. But let's go and use this embossing folder. Now, if some of you are new, and if you are new, make sure that you like and subscribe, follow, and, you know, do all the things so that you can come back and hang out with us again. Yeah, the more the merrier. And then we can do this again, like Friday is when we do this. And look, I missed a little piece right there. So there. Okay, done. I like to put these through at the same time because sometimes I use a 3/16 inch border, which is only three little lines on your Stampin' Up! Trimmer, bigger, because it just gives you a little bit of the colors, you know, of the border, and not a lot. I'm a little bit uneven, but you'll still take it if I put a $50 bill in there, right? Oh, see, Tammy's new to us, and I hope she'll come back. And Elaine thought the same thing. Huh. Yes. Well, I thought something, I want to put something, because this is rather busy, right? And it's rather dark. So what does that mean? That means that we should go lighter and less busy. But this is pretty busy, but we'll see how it works. I mean, it would have been, you know, we could have done like this, right? But that's really, you know, my go-to would have not, yeah. If I was going with something different than if I was going with yellow on the top, that would have been nice. I mean, yeah, there is no right answer or wrong answer. And see, this, that would work, you know, something floral or something plain. Okay, so let me get my sandwich right here. Yeah, it would help it. Yeah, every now and then I do have to do sandwich review. And make sure, I mean, I didn't pay attention to this for a long time, but make sure that you put it through fold side first, because one time we were here and someone, they didn't mean to do it, but it did happen, and it went right through the, it broke, right? It broke the folder. Could have used a new one too. Now this glue. That's beautiful. Even though yellow is not one of my favorite colors. Whoa, way too much glue. Oh, and look what I just did. Did you see that? Did you catch it? This is why you never have this stuff on the out when you're close to each other. Of course, now I have it on my, oh, hold on one second. This is 3.5 inches wide. Look at, this is a damaged one. So what I'm going to do, make it up as I go along. I'm wiping off the glue onto like some garbage over here. So this, I'm not going to cut another one. I'm just going to make it happen. And what am I doing? Putting this off to the side so I don't, that's something that came damaged and, yep. So we're going to cut That's a half. So we're going to cut 3/4 of an inch off. Now, if you're new, you notice that says score. That just reminds me to put that scoring blade up there. We're going to see about taking 3/4 of an inch off. I hope, see, look at, and then I tried to score it. I hope this is as fun for you as it is for me. But you know what? I think that's going to be not going to work. That is not going to work because I was remembering what this size was and not what that size was. And that I am going to have to cut a new piece. But that's okay. I can use that for another card base. That's just the thing, you know, when things go wrong, just kind of, that's when it's time to get creative. And sometimes even getting creative isn't enough. You just go and come up with plan B, because you just kind of figure that it's sticky right here. So I'm trying not to. Okay, Anne. You know, I only have it at the end of my hand. You'd think that there. Okay. Always make sure that you got the right side there. Marcy, what's the name of this embossing folder? It's in the catalog. I know that. I'm going to put this on with glue too. I'm not a big glue person, but I definitely don't want to use anything. I'm going to put any pressure. Cut a strip of DSP to fill the gap. No, it wouldn't. If I would have kept this other one, I'll show you what it is. This would have been, see, it would have gone off of the edge. It from here. See, to there, it would have gone off the edge and there was already adhesive on it. Okay, so let's go. We have to be thinking about what kind of greeting we're going to use. I'm going to leave that there for just a second. Would the old technique of roughing the edges fix that? No, I don't think so. I'm just going to save that for another card. That's it. First of all, let's see what's in here. Hope your day is just right. A friendship nurtured in love blooms forever. Each day is a new beginning. Hold on, let's look at this other stuff here. See, I have my calming camellia that I haven't used. Let's see. I love being your friend. Lovely you. Wow, those are nice. Would be nice for a happy birthday. That's a pretty happy birthday. I want to put that on there. I think it's going to be better down here than up here. That's just isn't it. So I'm going to commit. I was waiting until I got my greeting on there and I'm going to commit. Now here, this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to put this right on there. Each day is a new beginning. I just don't like the shape of that for that. I like what it says. Like, turn the fan on, Ann. Okay. Cool my brain. Ooh. Here you go. You make my heart happy. That works for me too. This is out of another new free set that you can get, because I think going right across there, of course it would be nice to have, you notice I put this on top of here, and that's just to make it connect, you know, like connect to it. I'm gonna look and see. Hold on. Ooh, whoa. Okay, here we go. Look at this. I think you're wonderful. Yeah, send me a card with that on it, right? Boy, this is, oh. Yeah, this is my go-to right here. For someone who is wonderful in each and every way. Or thanks for brightening my day. That might be a good one too. We haven't used that one yet. Thank you, Sandy. Okay, so I like to lay those down and then put this on top of it so it doesn't mess with it at all. I haven't even thought about what dye is gonna work. Oh, look at this. Wow. See, okay, so the other day we talked about was it Friday? I'm so confused. I guess it was Friday. We did organization and I talked about papers and paper scraps and stuff. Well, one of the things I do have the folders I talked about, and maybe on Friday I'll show those. But I do have a drawer that is right underneath my cutting station. And the only small scraps I keep, and like, I would call this a small scrap, but it's only because I have 10 of them, right? So they're perfect for if I'm gonna do a class or something, because I've already got that pre-cut and that's a greeting size, right? But I just put white vanilla, shimmery white, and black in there. And because those are really go-to for borders and greetings. And I think I'm gonna go with Mossy Meadow for this greeting. And then we'll try it in black too, you know. I don't know. Maybe I should just go for black. I think black's gonna pop more. Don't you? Yeah, cause this will blend in. So let's go with the black. Oh, that's a good idea. This one would probably. You're giving me an idea here. Now this is virgin, so you know it may or. Now, I should have a. Maybe I will. You know, a pokey tool mat, underneath this. But I usually don't do that only because I have a full pack of grid paper underneath. Good enough. I just thought of something. But what was it? Here's the cloud punch you were talking about. This won't fit in there. This would. Hey, let's go and do that real quick. We'll see how that is. Told you I had about 10 of those. This is not my go-to size, but that's okay. Good idea, Nancy Clark. I think I better punch it out first only because I don't know where that's going to be. Hold on. No, I'll be fine. Let me try that again. Hope I got it inked up right. See, I gave that a lot of power and it just didn't need it. I think this is going to make the difference. I like both greetings. They both say the same thing. If I wanted more color on here, I could probably. Actually, you could just put it on like that. Could put it over here like that. That's just too common. Just a little bit like that. Yeah. And put it on some dimensionals, and we could just go and punch out another one. If I needed more color on there, I could do it in blue, you know, sponge it in blue around the edge. That would work. See, look at what you made me, you helped me make a card, and I really appreciate that. So I hope that you'll come back and hang out with us on Friday. See, look at, I put this on dimensionals and this one on, however, I could stamp a flower on it. Yeah, maybe. I could, you know what? I think I'd redo this and do them both in shimmery white so that they shimmer a little bit, right? And put this one on with glue, put this one on with dimensionals. And, you know, maybe that would like block a cloud in somebody's day. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. And look at, I can turn down without seeing a skunk in the picture. Yeah, I could stamp a flower on it, but then those are clouds. I could stamp a sunshine and like right there. Whoa, yeah, right there. So that just part of it showing, and this is high, you know, it like a sun, some sun is coming out. Yeah. That's my story and I'm sticking to it. Yeah, but what set do I have that has a sun in it? All I need is a circle and some lines. That's all I need. That's all I need. Anyway, I don't need much, but I do need you to come and hang out with us again on Friday when we go live at 5. You know, I am just looking forward to every time I hang out with you and we make cards together because we're right here at in the stamp room and getting out the new stamps. And, you know, maybe we should go and look at some of those old catalogs and remake them with new stamps. I kind of think that's great. But you know what? I want you to stay warm. I want you to stay warm, stay dry. And after the storm. Yes. And some of you I'll see tomorrow night when we are doing the mystery card party. And if you missed it this time, make sure you come next time. This is Ann Clemmer and Domino from StamperDog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun.
Yes.
Into your day. Hey, God bless. See you live at 5. That's Friday.